channel, and do not forget to click bell icon so that you will get notified with any future videos which will be uploaded in our channel. So today the topic that we are going to see is how to remove and refit a main engine exhaust valve. So we are going to do it for a electronic type main engine, and I will try to give you maximum information about what are all the precautions that we need to take before commencing a job, and what are all the procedures that we need to follow while removing an exhaust valve, and what are all the things that we need to do before installing a overall exhaust valve in main engine. So do not skip any of our videos so that you don't miss any hint which I'll be giving during the video session. And in this video I will try to make it as a two part. So one part will be covering the removal of exhaust valve, and the second part will be covering what are all the procedures that we need to do before refitting a overall exhaust valve and how to refit a overall exhaust valve. So please continue watching both the parts so that you will get some idea about how we need to do a removal and refitting of a exhaust valve on board ships. Please continue watching this video completely. We'll go inside the video.
Today we are going to do the renewal of exhaust valve, main engine exhaust valve. We replace the exhaust valve with the overall exhaust valve. So before commencing the job, I had informed you already that we need to follow certain safety procedures. So in that, the one record is you have to ensure your spring air valve should be vented. So your normal spring gear condition, and this spring gear is connected to your exhaust valve, so this should be vented. So the spring fan pressure is zero now. Next is we have to isolate the cooling water for the particular unit which we are going to do. So for that we have to open the drain valve first. This is your drain valve. I open the drain valve. So this drain valve, when I open, when I start closing the inlet and outlet jacket cooling water valve, so we have to drain the water which is remaining inside. So that drain will come to this pipe and goes to the clean drain tank. So I will close the inlet and outlet valve for our number one unit. The drain valve that we need to close.
Inlet. Pop.
before starting any maintenance work in your main engine. So this valve is already closed. You can see the position. It is already closed. And okay. So now we are ready to start our job. So again, I tell you what are all the things that we need to follow. First thing, whenever you want to start any maintenance work on main engine, you have to stop the engine, close the starting air valve. And for this exhaust oil job, you have to stop the lube oil pump and you have to close the safety air and you have to drain your cooling water. So all this all done. Now we are ready to start the job. So let's go and start the job. Our cooling water line. Now we are opening our cooling water pipe which is connected to our exhaust valve.
Water away. Okay, give up.
We got two cooling water connections which goes to our exhaust valve. One is this pipe, the other one is this pipe. So we have to remove both the pipes. Opening the exhaust manifold bolt. So usually this exhaust manifold bolt, before you are trying to open, just put a coat of WD-40, so it will be easy for opening. So we are going to, we already almost finished opening our exhaust manifold side bolt. So next is, we have to remove the sensor. Sensor is here. This is your exhaust valve position sensor. Okay, this is one pipe which is a cooling water pipe. We dismantle from the exhaust valve. Connection is isolated from our exhaust valve, and this is your air connection. So we have to remove the air connection also. we remove the air line, and next we have to remove the lube oil line. So we have to dismantle it, or you can move it and keep it for going to an exhaust pipe. Remove the bottom connection for this pipe because you cannot be able to turn it, so you have to remove it.
Thank you.
are going to remove our, we are making arrangement to open our hydraulic nut. So before opening your hydraulic nut, the nut base is clean, the nut threads are clean. So we already do the cleaning of these two hydraulic nuts. So now we are going to use the hydraulic jack for opening your hydraulic nut. Place our hydraulic jack in place. Hydraulic jack in place. Now we are going to connect the hydraulic hose. The hydraulic jack. Now for opening the hydraulic nut, we have to loosen the jack nut one at a time. So I put the marking here, I open it, one turn, and come back, one and a half turn. Okay, so now it is open, one and a half turn. Now I am going to do the same, I fix for the other side also. So now I am going to activate our hydraulic pump. Increase the pressure. The opening pressure for this hydraulic nut is 2800 bar. So we are going to open it. Okay, so this is our hydraulic pump. And now we are going to increase the pressure. This is your air pressure, and this is your indication of your opening pressure, and this is your cycling valve, and this is your air pressure control valve, and this is your oil return valve. So for opening this, I have to close the oil return valve. So I'm closing the oil return valve. So now I'm going to increase the pressure. So I have to use the cyclic valve. Okay, now I am going to increase the pressure. Okay. Now you can see the pressure increasing. This indicates your opening pressure unit. So I have to bring to 2200 to 2300 bar so that the hydraulic nut should open. Opened the pressure, the hydraulic nut opened at 2400 bar. You can see there. You can see the nut got opened at 2400 bar. So I will open the nut 10 turns. So now I had opened the hydraulic nut. Now I am going to loosen, release the pressure. So whenever you are releasing the pressure, release it very slowly. Pop! Pop! So when you are releasing the pressure, ensure the nut is in still open position so that you can avoid repressurizing the nut. Now we have opened the hydraulic nut. Now we have to remove the hydraulic jack and open our exhaust valve nut. now you can see, now we are opening our hydraulic, this is our cut. Now we are opening our hydraulic nut. Okay.
Lift the exhaust valve. So whenever you are lifting your exhaust valve, you have to make sure all the connection are removed, and you have to lift it very slowly. So I am lifting it now. Next we will start preparing to install the overall exhaust valve in space.
Exhaust valve from a main engine, which is electronic type. I believe this video will be useful to you. Keep supporting our channel. Thanks for watching this video. In part 2, we will be covering how to refit the overall exhaust valve. Thanks for watching, guys. Thank you.